Yeah, they should. Yeah. The Wi-Fi is always weird when it's like raining outside, you know? Yeah, it's always a little bit slow in here. So we're gonna serve us some inches, you guys, with a little kick at the top. I thought we were gonna get like snow. Do you hear that?
I do.
Not so good. I know. I wish it was better than this. Right? All right, so I've got all, well, I shouldn't say that. It can be all low impact, but there's not a ton of jumping, but
yay.
We're going to try to get nice and sweaty here in the warm-up, so we're just going to hinge with a high kick for about 10 more seconds, and then we're going to do some seesaw lunges, but we're going to alternate legs, okay? Five, four, three, two. So you're going to go forward and back with your right leg, and then forward and back with your left leg. So if I go forward, and then I go back, and then I switch legs. Go forward and back on one side, forward and back on the other side.
So, frog is the body that retiring
right.
For a year.
How many?
A year.
Oh, okay.
Like a whole year. So, I feel like that's that long to adjust to it.
Yeah.
Because, like, the first reaction is really, oh,
right. What about you?
Oh, I still have a few more years to go.
Yeah. Well, that's exciting, though, at least. And then we're going to do our inchworms. And we can lead off the push-up and do some push-ups. So you're just going to go down and walk out to the plank here. And then once you're at the end, just walk your hands back up. And you can keep your hands down on the ground here. This is good. Bend the knees a little bit if you need to. Just work your way in and out. I smell like sausage. Like I made maple sausage. You know what I mean? Like maple sausage links.
Oh, yeah.
What about the smell on here? It smells, you can smell. It smells like syrup.
Right.
I should clarify. It doesn't smell like sausage. It smells like syrup.
Okay. That's a better smell.
That's a better smell. More here. Nine, eight, seven, six, five. washer and dryer. They were the only ones that carried the one that we wanted.
Okay.
So I had to go back to the big city.
Great. Commercial always cracks us up.
How do you like the couch?
What'd you say?
How do you like the couch?
Oh, wait, you're a couch. I don't have it yet.
Right.
But now I'm on the hunt. Come on up, Chris. We'll go to our squats. Okay, so either remember that pulse with that calf raise or pulse with a little hug. Now I'm on the hunt for like a chair.
A chair.
I need something, it can't be too big,
right?
Because it's not a very big canvas,
right?
It's kind of narrow. So, and I kind of want a recliner, or David does, but I don't want it to look like a recliner.
Yeah.
So I've got a couple options. He doesn't like buying something online without seeing it, but honestly, that's really the only thing I can find, right? Like at Wayfair, and I found one at Home Depot that I really like, which who knew that Home Depot has a calling
for you? Did that?
Yeah, it's been a while.
Have you checked?
I have not. So I need to go there.
It's worth, it's, you know, hit or miss. You never know what you're gonna have.
That's the plan for like all my bedding and my towels.
Oh, yeah.
I got a shower curtain though, that's really cute. So,
I love a shower curtain.
I do too, Sam. That's like my one. Literally, that's the first thing I bought other than the couch. I got the shower curtain. And I want some fun towels, ones that you don't touch.
Right.
Have you seen that meme where it's like, if you come in and use these towels, we can't be friends.
Yes.
Like, you don't touch these hand towels, right?
I need one of those.
Four, three, two, and then our seesaw lunges. I did go to World Market, too, yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
That place, man. I want everything in there.
I love that store.
So I gotta be choosy. There's like some lighting.
Rebecca, the desk.
You did there.
Go up there.
I love it. And they have some. They have some really. So that's. I looked at a couple places. Rugs. That's like probably my best place. So I got to pay it back. And he's kind of picky, but I need like two big rugs. So,
okay.
Which again, that almost excites me as much as the shower curtain, you know? Four.
Three. I miss Tier 1.
Tier 1? I did too. That's where my bedroom furniture is that the boys use downstairs.
Yeah.
And you know what I need, Sadie? I need to paint it, I think.
A what?
I need to paint it. It's wicker. It's like an olive green wicker.
Yeah.
And I don't know, I think I should just spray paint it.
But you can.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Go on YouTube, some people tell you how to do
You're
it.
You're right. I should just look up how to paint wicker furniture.
Yep.
That's a great idea.
Go look for your paint.
Right? Seven. Six. I wonder why they went out.
Huh?
I wonder why they went out, you know?
What went out?
Tier 1.
Oh, I know!
I know, right? Come on up. I got my first, that was my bedroom set from there when I was in high school. And then I got my first kitchen table there. That was like when benches were kind of coming like popular, you know?
Yeah.
That's another thing.
I love benches.
I like benches too. At least on one side, you know?
Yeah.
It's kind of cute. Eight, seven, six, nine, four, three, two. All right. We should be warm. That was like about 6 minutes. So grab water if you need it, and then I'm going to show you the first move. We're going to actually just hold the dumbbells in the first set here, and we're going to do squats and a deadlift combo. So you'll hinge on one. And then you'll just squat on one. So we'll just go between the hinge and then the squat. And then we're going to do some side lunges. I'll show you real quick in a second. Then we're going to end up going into like a side lunge. And then we're just going to come up and press it. So we'll push those hips back. And we'll do one side at a time. All right. Okay. So give yourself a little shoulder roll. Let me set my timer real quick. That way we can stay on time here. So everything is kind of quick, remember? So we got to make sure that we're kind of transitioning fast. All right, so give yourself a little shoulder roll. I would put my feet so they're right under my hips. Not too close, but not too far. Okay, you ready? Here we go. Okay, here it is. Let's do this. Roll the shoulders.
So one pinch and then one squat.
So you can go a little bit heavy if you like on this one. Do you have anything tonight?
No.
Does it work after this?
What's that? Get to work after this?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Awesome. 20 seconds, you guys. So I think, like, when I go back in that squat, imagine I'm just going to sit down in the boat chair. Is that good? 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, and then you want to go with one weight, one that you can press, and we'll just do one side at a time. So the best way to do it, okay, is to hinge over, and we're just press. So the leg I step with, the weight's on the opposite arm. Also, like sitting back, right? Like you're gonna tap your bottom right on a chair. It's weird, Sandy. It's wild. It's wild. Like it almost looks like it's completely gone. I can't. And there's no explanation for it.
Right.
It was literally like she was, it was
you can't even look at her.
It was so big. No, I will say this. Like, it subsided, but a little bit. But there's still, like, stuff coming out of it. And we can't really see it unless she gets up and lay down. And I can see a little bit of blood and, like fluid,
yeah.
Like where she was laying, and it was,
yeah.
But it's not bad. It was like, I mean, I was washing these towels every day, and she was laying on, so we just have all the furniture covered up. But she still pops up on the bed, and she sits in a little chair by the door, like a little recliner.
But there you go. Yeah.
But you know, weird is, watching her, she came so tall. She like pushes at her face. And I swear, it's like she's pushed this like out of her head. Yeah. Isn't that wild? Yeah. So, I think my prayers worked though. I was like, I swear. You're right.
Otherwise, I don't think it would have ever.
So I'm going to give you guys a little stretch. How's that?
No weight needed.
We'll just step in and then rotate over to the side. You know, I love these. They call it the greatest stretch in the world. You just step in and then rotate towards the leg in the front.
It does feel really good.
It.
So it's yoga this Sunday?
It is. You coming?
I am.
I am online.
And you don't have to.
Oh, I will.
Yeah.
So then, you know,
you're the VIP. I need you there. All right, one more. Then let's come back up and do that again. Okay. So make sure you've got a good amount of weight.
All right.
I'm going to go up to my 15s. Just for a little more, but let's start with that hinge and that squat combo. So give yourself a little roll, check your feet, right? All right, here we go. We're on two. Did you guys do anything on Sunday? Did you watch football?
Yeah.
That's what we did.
Yeah.
That was very sad. I really wanted the Lions.
Yeah, the Taylor's going to the Super Bowl. So.
Yeah. I know, that's pretty much all it's going to be. There's all this talk about her making it in time from Tokyo.
So that's what I heard.
Did you hear that?
Yeah. So when I watch Super Bowl, it's for the commercials.
Yeah.
And the music. Show.
Yeah.
Now,
are you happy about Usher?
It's, yes.
Yeah, me too.
Now it's for commercial.
Three things. Yes, I'm with you. I'm with you. I think he's so cute. And I'm there for the snacks, right?
What?
The snacks.
Oh, yes, I know. Definitely.
Although it always stinks because I always have to get up on Monday morning after. I should cancel my early class, right?
You know what? I bet they're going to watch the games.
I know. I'll have to have a conversation with my
girls.
If
I were in your class,
yeah.
I would suggest.
Especially if you're out at somebody else's house. Like,
yeah.
It's just a late night.
Yep.
And I never get to stay up.
No, I think they should definitely.
I think you're right. Okay, one more on that side, and then we're just going to literally pass it right up. And to the other side. My son, Will, is starting. He started yesterday, like a 40-day challenge. Like a food, like a diet challenge. I guess I don't really want to call it a diet.
This is
my youngest one. He just has a little bit of a problem. Have you ever met him?
No, but you told me.
Yeah. Well, we talked about our kids, you know, but.
So what's he doing?
Well, I guess his dad and his stepmom have kind of said they all want to do this together. Which they're not like, let's show you a picture. My ex is definitely game story, but like, it's not terrible. But they have all sorts of stuff. Like, I think he didn't have this when we were married, but he has like a gluten thing now that he does. Like, he does gluten free. So they already do gluten free, but the boys don't. My boys don't, you know. But I think Will's gonna start trying this gluten free. Yesterday he had a fast all day, which I cannot believe he did. She texted me this morning and said he fasted yesterday.
Why is he fasting?
I think it was just the first day. I don't know if you fast anymore during the challenge. But she sent me like the paperwork on it. Like,
okay.
And so I went today and bought him. Because he packs his lunch, which is always a stressful thing because he doesn't like fruits and vegetables. You know what I mean?
I don't know
what to do. So I went and got him a bunch of stuff. I got like pork rinds and Parmesan cheese crisps, stuff that he can do instead of like cheese pretzels, but they do gluten-free pretzels. Then I had to buy him like some bars, like some like small chocolate things, sugar-free Jell-O, cheese sticks, stuff like that. Like, I did buy some keto bread, which I don't know if he'll like it or like corn tortilla shells.
Right.
I spent a ton of money, but we'll see how this goes. I'm like, if it's works for him,
right?
Because I think he's gonna just have to go for more of like a, I don't want to say keto, but like low carb diet. He can eat, he'll eat all the meat, but he doesn't like fruits and vegetables. So I'm just gonna have to keep him.
So basically,
try to lose weight. Yeah. I mean, he's probably my height or. 5'6", he's like 180 pounds. So it's, and then the doctor has even said it's time. Yeah. All right, he's ready to switch. And he's not in a sport right now, which makes it hard. Like, I don't know how to get him moving, you know?
Yeah.
Other than taking him out. But when we normally go out, we always eat out. You know what I mean? So it's like, I gotta get him. He did the Peloton a little bit.
Oh,
and he likes
good.
That. So I try to encourage him to at least
just 15 or 20 minutes on that bike. Tomorrow I have a training at 4:15. It's a little boy, and I'm gonna make Will come. They're kind of friends, so I'm gonna make it.
Would he come with you like a?
I don't know. Maybe. They used to do my class like
back during COVID.
Yeah. And we were doing it from home, you know. All right. I just gotta get him moving, do something fun.
Yeah.
He went to the rec center on Saturday. Yeah, Saturday. So I think he was going to the rec center for him when we move, because that's where his friends go. They can play basketball.
Okay.
They can use the pool.
Do you like basketball?
He does.
Oh, so that's a great exercise, right?
And we finally live in Westville. Last summer when I was speaking about the rec, we were paying, it was like $20 every time. And now residents are like, it's like $30 a month. Like, I'd rather do that. You know what I mean?
Yep. Hey, guys. Great. Because he can be with his friends. That's half the battle.
Right. And I think he can leave. He has to cross one kind of busy-ish street. I think he can ride his bike there.
Yeah.
Two. Awesome. Okay. And then our little stretch there. Okay. And then I'll give you a chance to grab some water, all right? Start in your plank. Step your foot in right by your hand if you're going to use your hand. And then rotate over. I was the same way, though, I think. Didn't I tell you that?
Yes.
Not quite that much, but not far off.
So, how do you lose weight on a gluten-free diet?
What did you say?
How do you lose weight on a gluten-free
diet? No, I think for him, it's not just the gluten. It's going to be just portion control.
Yeah.
And, like, no sugar.
All right, that makes sense.
I threw out all the... like the candy and stuff that we had from like Christmas, and we still have candy from Halloween. He's one of those kids that will get like the sugary or the hard candy and just like sit there in like 10 wrappers deep.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. All right, gang, there it is.
That was good.
Grab some water. We're going to shift gears a little bit now.
Go
down on the floor and do like a quick ab circuit. It's abs and a little bit of arms. So you want a decent amount of weight. I have a 12 and a 15, and I'm just gonna have one of each close by. So one that's a little bit light and one that's like medium to heavy-ish. And I'll show you the first move here. Where basically you can not only keep your legs up the whole time, or as you come up, so it's just a small movement. Like you're literally just coming out and giving your abs like a little crunch there. And you can, like I said, you can keep the feet up or you can set the heels and bring the feet up as you bring that weight up. But it's just like a small, just isolated tummy crunch, basically. We'll go through the first set here. I'll give us a little longer. And then we'll do a little faster version. And you can give it a little pause even up at the top. Lifting those legs up a little bit really does help make it a little more challenging.
Yeah, it does. Bend it.
Yeah, it's getting the upper core muscles here. We're going to add some legs in just a second. Crunch hard. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to put the weight up and then we're going to put the legs up. And you're basically going to just drop one at a time and then bring it back up. You can let your head rest or you can come up with the weight, but really feel your lower back tightly against the floor. Like really press your back against the mat. So similar to a dead bug, right? Just a single leg dead bug here. Yeah.
4. 5. 4. 3. 2. And then we're just going to let the weight, okay, hold up here. And you're going to do your legs in and out right here. And you can do a single leg or you can do a double leg. But you want to be up in that crunch position. So your head is elevated and you're just bringing the knees in towards your chest and then pushing the heels out away from your body. This is pretty much going to be our floor work here. Instead of doing it at the end, we're going to get it done now. Sandy, it looks great. 7. And you guys look up, just relax your neck. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. And then we're going to do our little rainbow.
I call it a rainbow because you're going to like make more like a rainbow with your Russian twist. You want to lean back. I mean, you can elevate your feet if you want, but the weight's heavy. I would just let the heels rest and then just look to the right and look to the left. And that's it. We're going to go right back to the top here. About 12 seconds. I did this earlier and I'm feeling it already.
6, 5, 4,
3, 2. Awesome. Okay, right? So definitely a little bit of arms there.
So let's go back and start over. Started with our little, let's get a little crunch up, and you're going to bring those legs up maybe with it. A couple inches off the floor. Crunch. Sandy, do you think Asher is going to have anybody with him?
Do you want to be spot
back? Oh,
that would be cool if you did.
Yeah. You know how normally there's sometimes there's more than one.
Yeah.
And then we went up with it, right? One leg at a time right here.
Let's go up. What's the game? And
stay home. We'll probably just stay home.
Yeah, what about you guys?
We'll probably stay home soon.
And then just hold the arms, and now we go in and out with those knees. Now, if Detroit would be in it, it'd be a different story. We'd probably be.
Oh, really?
I told you my stepdad played for them, didn't I?
No.
Yeah.
Wow.
My brother.
That's cool.
Yeah. My brother's dad. Yeah. But he's been my stepdad since I was 2, so he's technically my dad.
Right.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Okay. So we were super excited. And then, you know, my brother especially, he was freaking out on Sundays.
Yeah.
But he played in the 70s. That was before I was even born, so.
That's still
super
cool.
And he's back up in Detroit now. He lives back up there.
Okay.
He's remarried. He lives in Novi? But I grew up, it was all Michigan sports. It wasn't anything from Ohio. Like Red Wings, Tigers, and Michigan State. Like there wasn't anything.
Nothing.
I never watched the Buckeyes. 7. 5, 4, 3, 2. All right, I promise this will be fast. Let your arms rest for a second. Okay, one more time.
Robin and Amanda went to the LSU Williams basketball game.
Yeah, that's fun.
For that crazy, talented woman. It's fine.
I don't know about this. Recently?
Yeah, like last week.
Okay.
What makes a trip unforgettable?
I love the next trip. It was from birthday present.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever been to one of one.
Tickets to yes, trash
this one because
things to do.
Opposing teams player.
Okay.
Like for them, they're good. And turns out OSU beat them.
Wow.
So it was really,
that's awesome.
Exciting game.
5, 4, 3, 2, and then our leg drops. One of the members here has season tickets for the wrestling, which is really cool. He let me, So I took, he had like 4 tickets. So I took the boys last year.
Oh, nice.
It was really fun. The place, the like arena that they wrestle in.
Yeah.
Is like just, the floor is like lower, you know, so you're kind of sitting up around it. Like, so you can see really well. I forget what building it's in, but it's over there, you know, by the Schottenstein Center. Right. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then just hold it up. So we get just like less than a minute, you guys. So in and out with those knees, strong arms, and then we'll do our little rainbow Russians, and then we'll be back up to our feet. Crunch in, you got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then let's hit those arms and those obliques, and then I'll give you a chance to go. We just knocked out a bunch of our core. So if you want to try to go maybe a little bit higher with your rainbow there, still make sure you get all the way over to the right and all the way over to the left.
I feel this.
Back, shoulder, core. I'm sweating too. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Yeah. Awesome. Very nice. All right. Good stuff. Okay. So now we're going to go back in with a little more legs here. So you guys want to grab a little water and then we're going to do a little combo again with some squatting. So we're going to add in, we're going to do one side at a time here. This is one of my favorites. So we're basically going to curtsy back and then come in and squat in the middle. Okay? And we'll do one leg at a time. So we kind of hit the inner thighs. Now we're going to hit the outer thighs a little bit here. So, all right. I would say hold one as heavy as you want. I'm going to probably just go with my 15, but we'll do these. Then we're going to do some bent flies. So we're going to start with one heavy, and you're just going to curtsy back and then come in and just squat. And you can tap that weight, and then you're just going to repeat. Curtsy back and across, and that squat in the middle right there. And then, like I said, we're going to do some bent flies. Now we're going to do some swings. We have like 2 quick circuits left, full body circuits. So we'll hit the arms and the legs here on the end, and we'll finish with a nice big plank, okay? Get some curtsy. And then trying to get those thighs right parallel to the floor. Easy breezy. And we'll pass it off the other side. And then hit that squat in the middle.
So, when I talk to Rob about retirement planning,
yeah.
You know, if you want to talk about pay, vacation, trips, you want to talk about flight.
Yeah.
First thing you said was, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Like, what do you want to hear my idea?
Right.
Well, I thought it would be fun. Sweet. The Clippers game.
Yeah.
Three. Has everyone come?
I think that sounds great.
He liked that idea.
He did like
lot.
That idea.
Yeah.
All right, because it gives you a little bit of sports. You know,
did
what I mean?
Not want to be the center of attention.
Right.
And have to feel that people were there for you. Know?
Right. Yeah, I like that. So you could do flies on this, or if you don't have the proper weight for the fly, then you could do more of a row. Let me show you here. So this is the fly, right? We're going to hinge. So you just want to hinge just like you do when you go into your deadlift. And then if you can't do the fly, you're going to go into a row instead. So just bent rows or bent flies. Do you think you'll go for it?
So you can spare you
three. Make those arms nice and wide.
And then
okay.
He said, I feel like we're in bed. We don't have any friends. He said, yeah, we do. So, and then we started thinking about dates. And that's
right.
When it got very complicated.
Okay.
But I would say he's a firm. He started out a definite no.
Yeah.
Definite
date. Okay. Awesome. 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, and then we're gonna go into our swings. And I would say just maybe the weight that you have right here, we're gonna do those double swings, those spear swings. You can always use one weight though, if you wanna drop down to just a simple weight. You guys are one away anytime soon, I forget.
That's what we're working on now. We
okay.
Figure out when we can go to Seattle to see Lauren.
Yeah.
And we kind of work around that.
Nice. Great job, you guys. I am going to add maybe some mountain climbers in on this set here. Okay, so let's keep swinging for another 12 seconds. And then you can do them off of your weight, or you can do them off of the floor. Right? You've got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Two. Okay, and then just a mountain climbers, just to give you a little cardio and a little bit of core. Like I said, you can do them off of the dumbbells here, or you can just do them off of the floor. All right, here we go. And then we're just going to come right back up and repeat that curtsy to squat. Right? Run those knees in 15, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Awesome. Okay. Decide what you think there. You want to go maybe a little bit heavier.
Okay, on this first one here. So we curtsy. I promise this will go a little bit faster here. What'd you get at high bank?
So, you like that? We went for a seasonal espresso martini.
Okay.
Your Evo.
Oh.
The regular espresso martini.
Okay.
I was just as happy.
What was the seasonal? What was the
different
chocolate
banana.
Oh my god, that sounds delicious. I'm with you on that. Like, I like that. I like banana
stuff. And we went for happy hour.
Right.
No, we're early because I'm with this
espresso martini. And they have happy hour all day, right?
Do they on Saturday, Sundays?
No.
Yeah, happy hour.
Oh, they have that $5 drink menu. Okay.
Monday through Friday.
They have their happy hour. I don't know if I've gotten any of their appetizers. We had their like donut balls. They were like donut or pancake balls. Like your birthday cake confetti ones. They were pretty good.
Really good Brussels sprouts.
I had that. That's good. I've had their biscuit, chicken and biscuit.
Oh, yeah.
Like on their brunch. It was good. And I'm pretty sure I think I had their burger.
But they had a hot honey pizza that I had that was really good. Have you ever had a hot honey drizzled on pizza? So good. Usually it's like a spicy pepperoni.
Okay.
And then they do this hot honey drizzle.
Yeah. Super good.
All right, so two things, right? You got your flies, then your swings. All right, so hinge here. Eyes in front of your toes. And then just give it a little fly. We're just looking for about 12 to 15 reps. If it's lighter, 15 reps. If it's heavier, you're going to shoot for about 12. And you want to keep your core tight. And eyes in front of your toes, right? 10 seconds.
Yeah, you got sitting.
Yep, I am this weekend.
This weekend?
Yeah.
So you have like a week off
and
you're
out of
the
gym? I know. Oh. Two. And one. I wanted to make sure my girl was going to be okay. And she should be fine with my mom.
as long as she doesn't take her to the bed.
David's like,
too early to laugh.
I know. David's just so frustrated with her.
Oh.
I'm like, dude, it's only like, we got like 3 more weeks. You're almost
there.
Focus on like your butt and the back of your legs, right? And the arms just kind of float along the sides. So give it that little squeeze at the top without pushing your hips forward. Or just kind of sat at the top, squeeze the glutes, get it. 7. Just like a little double cardio right here because you're going to go right to those mountain climbers. 3, 2, and 1. Those are good for your core muscles. So those swings.
All right, on the weights, on the floor, try to pull your knees in as far as you can, like towards your chest. I'm trying to get it towards those dumbbells. Okay. And we just kind of pick them up here as we go through it, right? 20 seconds. 15. Come on, 10, 9, 8, almost there. Oh, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Okay. All right. One more set, and this is pretty much it for the legs. All right. And finish off these legs, and then the last circuit, we've got shoulders, biceps, and some push ups. So, this is it for the legs. Give me the goods here, you guys. Got curtsy with your squat. Think of a burnout here. Like, try to keep the pace a little bit quick and really burn out. We got 25 seconds, and we'll go right to the other side. You're like, this went fast, I think. The last part is going to go super fast, and your arms are going to be really feeling it. 15. Very nice, Sandy. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, okay. It elevates your heart rate a lot there. I did get some new shoes. I was thinking of you. Look.
Huge.
I got the New Balances because I've got the ones that you have. They're like orangey, yellowy.
Okay.
And they're starting to get a little hole in them. So I figured it was time for a new pair.
Oh, that's very cute.
And you know what? I went down and looked because I wasn't sure. Normally I order a 7.
Yeah.
But in those, I had to order a 7.5. And I remember somebody telling me, you should always size up, like a half size, on like a running shoe.
Oh, okay.
So I did. I got the 7.5. And I'm perfect. Very comfy. And they were like $40. And I had a gift card. Even better.
Great. What did you
do? DSW.
Yeah.
I know. Me too. And then you just get all the rewards stuff.
I know.
You know? Okay, our bent flies. So let's really hit the upper back here, middle back. Or your rows, right? Or your rows. Oh, that got me right there on the squats.
Yeah. So girls and I wear almost the same shoe size.
Yeah.
All three of us.
Yeah.
So the shoe.
What do you wear?
I'm like a 6.5,
okay.
Seven.
Yeah.
the Lord's ID, eight, sometimes a six, but not often. Sometimes a seven, right? Seven.
Did that present a problem when they were younger? A couple more days.
Oh, hell no.
Okay, that's good.
They didn't want any
with each other. Yeah. Seven. Six.
We actually weren't the same size when we were six.
I always wanted to be the same size as my mom because she's like a big shoe person. But she's got like a whole, she's like a whole size and a half bigger. So it never worked out.
Yeah.
So I was like, dang, like, I wish I would have been the same size as my mom.
Lauren was always smaller and Amanda was always bigger. But now, I'll buy a pair of shoes and like, I could give it to you, it's a great price. I'm like, I gotta learn somebody else.
Yeah, that's a good way to do it.
Or, I find something really good. My three-year-old?
Yeah.
Can you imagine shoes?
So cute. I love it.
It's fun.
Yeah,
it's fun.
16 seconds. Remember, kind of squeeze your booty at the top. You got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then we finish with those amount of five respirations. We go 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, ready? Okay, so we are doing shoulder presses, bicep curls, push-ups. And we're going to go down to about 20 seconds of each move. So it's one of those fast circuits. You've got 25 seconds. Drive up towards your chest. Keep your bum down. A little bit faster, 15. And hit the gas. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Oh, that was good.
Okay. One more chance, maybe a quick sip of water, and then I'm going to adjust my clock here. And then your shoulder presses and your bicep curls might be different size weights. So whatever you normally press overhead might be a little bit lighter than what you like for your bicep curl. So you guys grab if you need to have different size close by there. Okay, so we're going to have to make a quick transition when we get down to that push-up. So just know that you got to move kind of quick through this. So shoulder presses are first, and then we'll go right to the curls. All right.
So we'll see. I got my 15s, but I got my 12s close by just in case I want to go down in weight.
All right. So we're going to start with those shoulder presses. We're just going to do regular shoulder presses. Palms facing in, elbows in just a tiny bit. You're not straight out to the side, you're angled in just a touch.
All right, guys, you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, here we go.
We're just going to keep it simple, right? The goods here. Shoulder presses, and you can always do one shoulder press at a time if you need to. All right? And you got 12 seconds, and you're going to go right to your biceps. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Okay, and then you're going right here. Yeah, swap it out when you need to. Go right to the front of the shoulder there.
Already
it does. I might have to use those 12s. Yeah, or like that. You can go one at a time. I like that. 12 seconds. You got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Back curls. Just nice stretch curls. All right, elbows in. You don't let your elbows leave your body. Good. Good. Use your little bit of your back, right? Strong through your legs. We have 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, and then our push-ups. Oh. So just think, 2 minutes left, you guys, after this. Okay, 2 minutes. 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3. There we go. Round 3. I am going down. I'm going to my 12 now. There we go. Final 2 minutes. What's for dinner? You know?
Any ideas? What are you having?
We're having orange chicken, I think. From Trader Joe's. Have you ever had it?
No.
You go to Trader Joe's?
I love Trader Joe's.
So you need to get the orange chicken.
Oh, we have first section?
Mandarin orange chicken?
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good.
All right.
And you know what I do? I bake it on a baking sheet, and then I lightly sauce it on mine. I barely use any sauce. So you can control it. I mean, it's still like fried little pieces, but they're so good. It's not chewy at all. I don't like it. A lot of times I don't like chicken strip because the meat is weird to me.
Yeah.
If it's really good, like chicken, if it's,
I got tuna.
Yeah, it's good. And you know what? I got a bag of, push-ups. I got a bag of frozen broccoli. So okay. I'll just do that and then I'll just make some rice.
Oh, I don't know what I'll make for Will, but I didn't think
you
that
much.
I know the chicken breast I can make him and put a little bit of sauce on it.
You might eat the broccoli?
Yeah. Maybe you might eat the broccoli. If it has a little bit of that sauce,
And I guess roast is not gluten-free, right?
Yeah. That's why the chicken, I don't think you can have, but I do have some frozen chicken breast, like, real quick. Sauté for him. All right, last set. My arms are feeling like jelly. Not really, guys.
Feeling like jelly.
Last night I made something I had seen
on like Instagram or something. A jar of regular sauce and then a jar of Alfredo sauce. And you just dump them in the crock pot
with chicken breast.
Ah! And I let it go on high for 4 hours. I didn't shred the chicken up, I kind of diced it up. I pulled it out and just kind of diced it. And then put in a little bit of baby spinach at the end. And then you can just serve it over like anything. We have like ravioli left over. So there's a ton left. So it's like a chicken parm. It was so easy.
Alfredo sauce with what?
With regular marinara sauce.
Regular.
One jar of each. And I put in like two really big chicken breasts. I mean, they were like monsters. They were technically probably like four.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like four small ones. Oh, so easy. And I was thinking I could have just dumped the ravioli right in there because it was so saucy. I could have just let it. Let's do a couple more seconds here. Okay. These are it. Final reps. Let's go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Okay, how about this? 10 push-ups, and then we're just going to hold a little plank, but I'm going to spice up the plank a touch. So let's just go right into the push-ups, get yours done, and then meet me in a low plank. All right, team? We're going to do some of those little knee drops that we did on Saturday. 10 push-ups. 10 push-ups. Tummy's in. All right, once you're done again, me in a low plank. plank position. And we're just going to start by dropping one knee at a time, and then just kind of pedal your heels out, which this is great. Again, lower abs, right? My shoulders are feeling it, but I'm not going to be here too long. We've only got about a minute. We pedal and then we hold, okay? Pedal it out. 12, 11, and just keep rolling those heels back. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and now we're going to just dip the hips, a couple dips side to side here. We hit those obliques with our rainbows. Just a couple more here for the sides. And then we'll lock it in, okay? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then we just hold. Okay. Oh. Right? So not a lot of chest tonight. We got a lot of arms, but we'll focus a little more on the chest on Thursday. We definitely got our biceps, triceps, and shoulders.
Oh,
right? Shoulders for sure. And lots of legs, like lots of core. Okay, you got 12. Tell me your name. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And there you have it. Awesome.
Oh.
Lots of arms and abs tonight. Great job.
Goodness.
Thank you so much, you guys. Awesome for fun. Feeling that tomorrow. All right. Good work. Thank you.